You there, what is your name?
Lance, Li Xiuwen!
Hello everyone! Welcome to Brick Armor Gaming, my name is PM, and welcome back to Fate Grand Order! I Pluribus Unum, this Singularity! Okay, alright, so in the last episode, we learned that somehow the plan to assassinate Med went on a disarray. Somehow, I'm not quite sure. So Robin took the chance to get out of there and message the others, which means me and Mash and others, that somehow the mission failed. So let's take a look see on what will happen next. Should I change? Let's try it. Oh, they're still fighting, okay.
Oh, spirits that walk this earth, by the true name of, lend me your power, unleashing noble phantasm, Chago de Himalaya.
Oh, okay. What is that? Did he turn into a beast or something?
How, Agi Gandiva? My spirit pulled with a single blow, as expected from the strongest hero of India. But I don't understand. You possess such power, yet why?
I have no reason to fight Karna. Ugh.
Take this!
You can even repel bullets? The fact that a modern weapon like that can harm me is praiseworthy enough. Well, thank you.
However, it won't reach me. I'm sorry, but I'll settle this now. Ugh. Sorry, Geronimo.
Don't tell me they died!
Damn it, I wish I had a little more of this one. This is the end. Azura, you're decent. You still have a sound mind. Why did you join them?
You can't answer them, can you, Azura?
Demon. To think you'd serve Kukulain.
Of course I would. I mean, who decided for himself to become king? Not out of righteousness or nobility or even ambition. He just wanted to hide in himself. The ones you sent to Alcatraz will be finished off by Beowulf, Fionn, and the army.
Not really.
Well, even if they fell too, that's not a problem. Your defeat is already certain. So long as you have the Grail, this world will persistently continue to reincarnate. All that left is to destroy Edison's army. That's easy.
I see. So you don't actually know yet.
Don't know what?
It seems you think that you're some sort of chosen one to have obtained absolute power. But actually, you're just one of seven. Indeed, the fact that you obtained the Grail is proof of your greatness. However, really, it is rare, it is not the only one. If anyone has the only one, it is us. We have already recovered four Holy Grails. That is why, even if we fall here, others will take our place.
I see. But none of you have a chance against our king, a mad king and a war king. Two stands at the pinnacle of power.
As a shaman, let me make a prediction for you. Be glad you'll die happy. Unfortunately, it'd be real soon.
Arjuna, go and chase down the servant who escaped.
Understood.
Now, Ku, do you want me to help?
No, it'll be over soon.
Nero is defeated.
You can't maintain that bounded field anymore. This is the end.
Yes, with so many parts of the theater destroyed, I have no choice but to yield. However, I'll ask one thing. Consider it a final tribute to the defeated.
What?
It's fine to hone your skills, your strength, and become king, even if the rule you impose is tyrannical. However, how can you act without raising one eyebrow? I'm not trying to cast doubt on your conscience. You're not enjoying this in the first place. You are neither a king rewarded by the smiles of your people, nor striving for your dream. What exactly do you seek then?
I seek nothing. I don't need rewards. I don't even hope for the place to rest at my destination. This is how I am. I merely charge forward until exhausted. I could say, if anything, wherever my corpse lies is my destination.
How absurd. You decided to live as a king, yet you have no interest in gaining anything as a king. You are mistaken. Those contradict each other. The only path that you is to abandon one or the other, to killing.
But I see. But in reality, as you see here, I am the victor and you are the vanquished. Now die, Emperor of Rome. It matter not if I'm torn of pieces.
Game over. How disappointing. It seems my performance ends here.
What a pleasant feeling that pierced not just your heart, but also your other organs too.
I'm sorry, Lance. I wanted to sing together with you.
I see, it's over. Now all that's left is that servant named Robin.
You make it sound like you were there for survival.
Press the attack and crush them.
Yep.
Who?
Over there.
Over what? What's over there?
This is your designated place. Master.
Robin's fighting. Robin Hood's fighting. Alright, let's all head over there. Quickly. Sorry, I end up running into a along the way.
One of two, okay.
Oh yeah, humanoid! I forgot.
Wow, okay.
Nice. Nice. That's fun. I think a one woman barrage can do this.
Yeah.
How much? Ooh! That's
technique.
There we go. So what exactly happened out there? Well, here's the gist of it. That's about it. Geronimo, Billy, and even Nero. That idiot. We finally got to be summoned in the same era by some miracle. Sorry, I'll be over there for a while. Awesome. Sure. Still, impressive that you managed to escape such a situation. Did you use some sort of trick? I would never manage to pull it off alone. There was a servant who lent me a hand. A hand? Who? So persistent! That goes for both of us. I'm sorry, but I must shoot you down. Your bow isn't graceful enough. As a fellow archer, allow me to teach you a few things. Don't tell me! Hmm? Ah, it's Jasper! Okay, I thought it was Kana, okay. It's Jasper. So weak. You're well trained, but you don't put any heart into your attack. You're like a growing child throwing sticks. Who are you? I pride myself in putting my full might behind that attack. I have no obligation to answer. Just remember me as a god player who spent past by. I decided to allow that boy to escape with his life. Now withdraw, youngster who was nearly adored by gods. Being told that doesn't compel me to withdraw. No, stand guard, Arjuna. That woman is too much even for you to handle. Ow. I'm telling you, you're in the way. If you're around, you're just going to get hurt. Or what? Are you trying to hold me back? Does that mean you're a traitor too? Understand. Good. Listening to others is a good thing. A good child unlike you, Satanta. Keep calling me by my childhood name. What a headache. You think even you were summoned here. Those are my lines, fool. That's how you speak to your mentor. But I've always been like this. So, are you my enemy? Why yes, you know how it goes. If you see a rabbit dog in your flower garden, you wouldn't just sit around reading, would you? It can't bear to see the fool you become. Though a fool, you're still my student. I should behead you out of mercy. Now answer me, Tutulane, what has possessed you? No need to answer, huh? In that case, the only thing left for us to do is fight to the death. However, it seems the circumstances won't allow us to. I must allow that pale boy in green to speak. Have that burden in left behind you. If you fight, things won't end well for either of them. So it will be, oh king who came back to me. Use everything in here and come to lighten your burden? You must be joking. Knowing you, you'd take Ned out the second it starts this fight. Of course, I can't stand that woman. So I might just impale her with the best trust of my life. You won't fight me. I let that archer go. No, you will get out of my sight too. Come back again when everyone has died off. So no one can stand in our way. Very well, that will be my duty anyway. When you no longer have a way to die, I'll kill you with a smile. And she disappeared. I feel going to escape from the battlefield, huh? Not going after them? She's not someone who go down so easily. She can handle even 1,000 spears. I threw her up to wait. I can't win unless I'm ready to die. When I fight her, and when I fight her again, it will be when there's no one left to kill.
Wow. Deep. Robin, that woman who you said saved you, if she's Cuckoo Lane's mentor, then she... I'm right here. Is this some sort of forcing spell? I can't say it's in good taste. Poor disposition too. Nice to meet you too. I should introduce myself. My name is Skatach. Although I'm sure some of you already realize that. Skatach, mentor of Cuckoo Lane and a guardian of the Land of Shadows? Yes, that's right. Oh, needless to say, I'm different from the other Celtic servants. Perhaps it's because I'm special being beyond human. That prayer cannot rule over me. There's a reason I materialized as a heat-bold spirit. It's a special one too. Although all of humanity was incinerated, as was my realm. And so, being dead, I was summoned here. In a proper version of history, I wouldn't even be able to talk to the living. From that perspective, I'm glad about the current incident in a way, but no, there's nothing to be glad about. My student was already foolish enough, and now I see him in even a more unsightly, idiotic form. I came here to put a collar on him and take him back, but it seems there's something on his mind as well. I considered putting an end to everything, including this era, but then I saw you. This war isn't something that heroic spirit should settle. It must have been solved by human hands. That archer, a part of that cause, was in a dilemma. I couldn't bear not to lend aid. Yes, you seem rather ordinary, but there is strength in your eyes, a good master. Isn't that right, Mash? Yes, thank you very much. I am proud of my master. Anyways, Kathash, would you fight alongside us? That'd be difficult. I can lend a hand, but I can't join you. As I said before, I don't have the means of repairing this error. All I can do is kill. Also, I doubt I could win against that Cuckoo Lane. What? You're Cuckoo Lane's mentor, and even you can't win? I'm shocked myself. Nothing can be more irritating. That is the Cuckoo Lane I know, and at the same time, he isn't. It's likely because of Meb's wish upon the Grail. She wanted the fool to become a wicked king rivaling herself. As a result, a cursed warrior with nothing but the power to become king was born. A fine god or a mad king, covered from head to toe in spines of death. That is the current Cuckoo Lane. Pitiful. Most pitiful. That thing is painful. That fool felt even one thorn unmanageable. So he must be out of his mind with a thousand. But by paying such a price, he has surpassed me. They say an idiot without hesitation is strong, yes? That isn't strength. It's simply confining one's life inside a cage. That's called failure. Beings that don't reach outside are nothing but delusions. Indeed, either way, this isn't just a matter of defeating Cuckoo Lane alone. Considering overall damage, King Meb has priority. The Holy Grail must be taken from that woman. Oh, don't expect much from me. I'd destroy the Holy Grail alongside with Meb, but that puts you back at square one. You're right. If the Grail is destroyed, repairing the foundation of humanity will be difficult. That would put a huge time loss for us. If possible, we need to recover the Grail intact. Let's consider Lady Castle to be our last resort. I want you guys to try defeating Med by yourself. Med, the legendary queen of the Kelps. Yes, she is a woman who is honest about her own desires. She is engrossed in taking over a nation at the moment. That woman, along with Cuckoo Lane, those two alone are enough to take any nation. Yet, they also have Ajurna, and I suppose they will still be alive as well. He's rather capricious, so we have no idea that he would do what he would do, but it's certain that he would side with the enemy.
Doesn't it seem a bit noisy around us?
Hey, look! They're coming to attack us! What should we do?
Hold our ground!
Yes, I'm sure angry. I'm super angry right now. I'll stand with all the stuff.
You should go too. We must retain this camp as the front line for the West.
Yep. Are we going to fight that?
Ah, lighthouse. They'll be difficult for those machines to handle.
Master, come with me. I'd like to see your talents.
I don't see any servants with them. Overcome this situation first.
Got it.
Yes, good answer. Now, on your way.
One of three.
Okay.
A lot of power up.
Okay, next one.
Not bad, but how about the next one? Next one. Why Vincent came near us? Curse you, maybe summoning things like that.
air, land, and air. Servants must understand their own roles, and the master must provide appropriate commands to kill those off. Trouble won't be tolerated. Now go! Why, man? Okay. No, dragon, okay. Shima Kana! Okay, nice. Then himself. And let me guess, the Chimera. Warriors among the Celts. Although they're giving up their humanity, they're as swift and strong as servants. But if you have trouble here, you'll never reach peace terrain. Know your servants and use them well. Don't disappoint me, understand?
Jaguar. Alright.
Yeah, here and I are the work.
Nice. Ooh, what's that? 15K!
More jaguars,
right?
Okay.
You wanna see a rider defeating an assassin? Bam!
Okay, now it's time for you. Okay, last battle. There are more three assassins, I didn't notice that. I'm gonna choose Shigo Yang for this one. can you catch me?
Burn into a pit.
Taken by Boulder.
Thrown by the wind.
Okay, last one.
Shadow servants have appeared, that Med seems to understand how to use the Holy Grail.
These are raids that couldn't become servants. They are one step shy of becoming heroes. Or they are heroic spirits that became shadows due to the summoner's lack of ability, improper summoning, circles, etc. Thus, you could say that they're being closest to servants. Make sure to defeat them. Humans have no chance against them.
What?
The black things that are disappearing one after another.
A servant, however, not a Celtic one.
He seems to be from near my country.
Chinese, perhaps?
Doesn't look like an enemy.
I've got his name!
But he is an elf.
But is he an elf?
Regardless, his technique is quite impressive. Abilities like that are impossible without both any talent and hellish training to forge one's body.
Excellent, most excellent.
It makes me itch for a good fight.
You there, what is your name?
Lance.
Li Xuwen! Li Xuwen!
Well met, servant of King Spears. A storm has been raging within me ever since I caught sight of you. It will not subside until I defeat you.
Accept my challenge.
Oh, you challenge me?
Naturally.
I know the reason why I was summoned. Still, I can't help it. I'm filled with selfishness after all. I must try and see if my spear can reach the gods.
This man is likely like a famished tiger or a starving wolf.
What a great potential person I have. I mean talent worth training.
Lancer Li Xuwen, if this was the land of shadows, I'd train you right away.
However, I belong to Master Toss already, thus things must be done in order. First fight, mash, and win. If you do, I, Scatter, shall face you directly. However, if defeated, you must be gone immediately.
I see. I understand. Very well. Mash, I hereby challenge you to a duel.
But I don't have any reasons to fight.
I am confronting you. Is that not reason enough?
If that's still insufficient, then consider me as a servant hiding with a cult.
Master.
You have the fight.
Yes, I see your master has good judgment.
That's right, I am your enemy. That should be beyond a doubt.
If you don't treat me as such, you will die.
I understand. Master, please provide your orders.
If I know if... Is there a way to summon Li Xuwen? Because he is one of my favorite assassins in Fate Extella. No joke. He has one of the coolest moves in Fate Stella. Should I try playing Fate Stella later? I'm not really quite sure. Anyways.
Li Xuwen! I like you as an assassin! Never.
But I do have a berserker that can damage humanoids, so yeah, tough luck.
Hmm.
Oh, dang it! Damn, he's strong!
He is freakishly strong!
I like it.
Oh, I wish I can summon him as a servant. I want him in my roster.
Thank you!
You're giving me the chance to kick your ass.
Oh, damn it.
If I knew he had a raid, I should not have used the third skill of Drake. But I wonder what will his MP be? I'm quite curious. Because if he's an Extella, he can one hit you. One hit. Shen Kuang Yu Erda.
Ooh.
That was freaking cool. That was freaking cool.
And here comes my Tamamo Tap! Okay. And he is dead. This match is over. Ah, nice. He's really strong. That's my line. To think you could you'd stand so well against him. If we're to fight seriously to the death, I have no idea which way the scales would tip. Scathus, I'd like to rescind my previous request. Oh, is that okay? All of you perhaps stand a chance against those cults. I may be a scoundrel to catch from society, but I even don't enjoy watching the world fall to ruin. You, who's not human, protect this boy with that shield of yours.
I will.
Now then, Scatter, I have a request. Regardless of whether this world is saved or not, would you face me at the end? Farewell. That is, if I survive until the time comes. You don't seem like one who would die so easily. Alright, I have one more thing to say, to tell you. This is simply my inference. But it seems that the king of inventions is possessed by something. Perhaps a good whack in the head while you wake him up from his endless dream. Ishuin, would you care to fight alongside us?
I'm sorry. I can say with confidence that I wouldn't attack you if I continue to be around you. If I was in my older body, I may have withered and settled down a bit. But I can't help it, as I was summoned in my physical prime. Why, fate allowing, we may yet fight alongside each other. Farewell.
And he's gone. As expected of Li Shuwen in his prime. So rough. He's a knife that cuts you just by touching it. Master, if I may, I believe I should go and see the patient.
What patient?
Edison, King of Inventions. According to what that servant said, he's supposedly possessed by something. I agree with his opinion. Even considering my knowledge as a servant, that being too foreign in nature to say he's Edison, King of Inventions. In that case, it must be an illness. We should meet him again. Things are starting to sound crazy again. He captured you before, yet you want to meet him again? I believe so too, however. What are you saying? There are many infected areas. In situations like this, triage is important. Master, what should we do?
Let's go to Edison.
Right. I think that's the correct thing to do too. I guess it's my intuition as a servant. I feel like we can't leave him like this. Then we should go immediately. We'll head straight there. Church by the shortest route. We need to knock that hard-headed man out of his cup with some anesthesia, then wake him up. Robin, Elizabeth, Rama, you've heard your master's opinion. What do you think?
Well, to be honest, my head hurts so much I'd like some anesthesia myself. I'd leave the decision to master.
Everything until now has been right, so I'm sure it'll be fine going forward. I'm still one who's better off acting alone. And besides, that Pressy King, was it? Why would I take that effort to meet someone I know I'm incompatible with just by how you describe him? Are you saying you'll just casually go and assassinate two killings for us? I don't do crazy things like that. As long as there are other means, at least. If you can do it, just to say so. We just can't honestly agree things, can you? To think, you of all people would tell me that, I should probably just shut my mouth and go along with it. I have faith in our master. If we all stand together, we can even defeat Karnak if needed. Now, master, let's go and wake Edison from his dream. So, the next episode will be fighting Edison himself with Helena Blavatsky and Karna. This is going to be a tough customer. But who doesn't like a challenge? Alright, so thank you for watching. If you guys have any questions or suggestions for the next game that you want me to play, please leave it in the comment section below. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next episode.